patrol, Earl.
Hey, boss.
Pull over up here.
Counselor?
Eddie, we had a deal. Either pay me or go with a public defender.
Another $5,000?
Ten.
Oh. Ain't you gonna count it?
I just did.
Ah, it's the middle of March, and you know what that means. Time for a forgettable courtroom drama starring Matthew McConaughey and Ryan Phillippe. Based off of Michael Connelly's book of the same name, the Lincoln lawyer stars McConaughey as super lawyer Mickey Haller, who operates his firm from the backseat of his Lincoln sedan. Haller soon signs on to a high-profile rape case where he defends rich kid playboy Louis Roulet. Now, the spit hits the fan when his life gets threatened after he starts doubting his client's innocence. The first two-thirds of The Lincoln Lawyer, it's the kind of stuff that can bore paint that's drying. Now, with all his talent, director Brad Furman he can't quite get a focused performance out of any of them. For instance, Tomei plays Haller's chummy ex-wife. Obviously, there's going to be some history between two people who've been married and have a little girl together. Or at least you would think so. Whenever they're together on screen, it's almost as if they're in separate rooms. They just don't gel. And think about it. If the characters don't even care about each other, how are we supposed to care about them? The answer? We don't. And you know what? Watching people we don't care about spew out legal jargon? It's boring! From frame one, Furman doesn't even know what kind of movie he's trying to make. The camera has that annoying new trend where it shakes erratically, saying, "This world is gritty!" Yet the content is anything but that. Professionally, the guy is like he's the greatest defense lawyer. No matter what's thrown his way, he's as cool as a cucumber. I don't know about you, but to me, Superman would be boring without kryptonite. Sure, there is something interesting about a guy that can keep his cool even faced with danger. But we need that moment where we start doubting his ability to keep his cool. Something has to come along that shakes his foundation to its core. Someone close to him dies. Yes, this moment's coming! And it does, but good luck trying to remember it. Ultimately, the movie does pick up pace in the last act, and it does provide 20 decent minutes after an hour of pure boredom. But you'll have to ask yourself, is it really worth wasting 2 hours of your time watching formerly pretty people have meaningless conversations just so you can listen to some music you can download at home? I think not. I would give it a 1.5 out of 5.